to Hidden Shed. So today I'm going to be making a pencil pen holder which will sit on my desk and just store some quick access like stationery, so pens, pencils, rulers, rubbers. So here I have a 4x4 piece of pine. It's really not the best piece of wood, but I don't want it to be anything special. So I've just got a quick tri-square. I'm going to really roughly mark how long I want it. I'm going to try and keep an inch either side of spare while I will skew off. And so there's quite a big knot there. So I might square it off here. And then work along. So I have to make two cuts. So there. And there, so if I zoom in for you guys, there will be this piece of wood here which will be turning. So I've cut the scrap piece off, but now when I compare it to a pencil, which is probably a few, maybe 3-4 inches off its original height, this should be fine. Obviously by the time I take probably that much off the top and the bottom, so I think we'll get turning. So guys, I think we will get going. I've got it between centers and we'll start to bring it down to round. So I've got it down to round, and I'll give it sort of the shape I want. I want it sort of like a slopey sort of shape, so gradually getting bigger as you go down to the bottom. And basically what I'm going to do now is, obviously I've turned a tenon on the end for the chuck. I've cleaned this edge up. So I'll put the chuck on. And we'll start hollowing. When I was getting some really nice plain cuts with gouge, and I pretty much finished off with the Rhino scraper. And I did forget to say at the start of the video, always remember to wear safety gear. Obviously I'm wearing a respirator and some massive great goggles. So we'll take the tailstock away. Just quite a chunky little piece of wood. Should be pretty cool when we're done. So I was just trying to get a rough shape and a rough all round thickness. And I think, there we go, we'll move the tailstock out of the way. And if I can see it, which I can't, we'll take, there we go, I'll just quickly pop the centre spinner out, and on my lathe you take this little piece off here, and then I'll put the chuck on. Okay, and we should be able to mount it in the chuck now. So if we just tighten it up, so this chuck is a, oh, I forgot what this chuck is now, it's a, ah yes, a Record Power Supernova. Really good, like really good beginner's scroll chuck in my opinion. So obviously it's quite a bit off center, but obviously we'll clean that up and we'll finish tightening up. Okay, and we'll put the tailstock back. So the video I did last was cleaning my lathe bed. The video I'll do next will probably be taking care of the tailstock. There we go. Let's try and clear it out a bit. And make sure we got clearance. And we'll tighten it down at that. Okay, and what I will do is I'll get it down to centre, or at least now it is on the chuck, and then I will start hollowing. Now, I would love to use a ball gouge to hollow, it's just I have a new one on order because every other one I broke. Alright guys, as I said earlier on, I don't really have a bowl gouge. I was currently doing the hogging with scrapers and basically I picked up the wrong tool, and really it is incredibly dangerous to turn, bowl turn or hollow, obviously hollowing with a bowl gouge. No, sorry, not with a bowl gouge, with a roughing gouge because of the wings they catch, and that's pretty much just what happened here. Luckily, I think the project's all right. I'm all right. What I think I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take the project out. Put it back in. Check the right way, actually. I may have knocked it off center. And it hasn't, so there you go guys, there's a lesson. Don't turn or hollow with a bowl gouge. No, roughing gouge, not a bowl gouge. That's what you need. I think I'm gonna put my Jacob's chuck in and drill a hole, so I'll have a go at that in a sec. So I've drilled the hole pretty deep, so basically I've set my tailstock off center to the actual center of the chuck, so I'm actually boring a much bigger hole than the drill bit. So if I zoom in, there's the drill bit compared to the actual hole size. So I think I'm going to carry on. So obviously if you didn't know what a Jacob's chuck is, it's pretty much a drill chuck which goes in your tailstock. So I'm just using a brad point bit. And this will pretty much give my tools somewhere to almost fall into. So we'll do it again. So my tail stump is stopping my Jacob from actually reaching. So there we go. Alright, should have much more room. So I just bottomed my spread out on the tailstock. So there's a little tip for all you guys. If you bottom your tailstock thread out, just grab, obviously in my case I've got a Jacob chuck in, just grab it and start winding it back. So I think that's as deep as we're gonna go. I haven't gone all the way through. I've cleared quite a bit of material out, so I think I'm gonna carry on. So I've pretty much bottomed the hole out, which we drilled with the Jacob's chuck. So I think I'm going to put a bigger bit in the Jacob's chuck and try and hollow some more out with it. So guys, if you are new to woodworking and you're going to attempt or do this project, and you're going to use the same method of boring out with the Jacob's chuck, never, ever, under any circumstance, use self-driven bits. It is just, obviously the bit's staying still, and you're advancing it forward, the screw will grab hold, and all of a sudden this will keep pulling the tailstock until it hits the chuck. So never, ever use these. So guys, I actually think we can begin sanding now. So I've re-centered this again, and to be honest with you, I think that is the deepest we're going to get, because my tools have gone pretty blunt for some reason. I did turn some oak 3 or 4 days ago, that's probably why, but we'll just start the sanding process. So as per usual,
So I'm gonna try and use this. So sanding wheel, just put it in your drill, and then obviously I'm gonna go up through the grits in the sandpaper.
So I'm just gonna start with some ordinary bog standard sandpaper. I think I'm guessing it's around 50-60 grit. So let's keep going. collection of sanding discs, sandpaper. So here we have some 400 grit. This is 33C, so this is Turner sandpaper. I'll use some of that. And then we also have some, I believe this is 120 grit, some more 33C. We just have a massive selection. Again, so this is 300. These are again smaller 33C pads. So we're just going to work our way through the sandpapers. And I lied again. Now I have teak oil as well. So either superior Danish oil or teak oil. Now Danish oil, it's very thin, whereas teak oil is pretty thick. I think we're going to go with Danish because I haven't used it for a while. I'm going to go about cutting the knob off the end. Is obviously now it looks like I've just put it back in the chucking, which I obviously have, but I've left about a mil gap all the way around for the tenon saw to go in. Obviously I'm using a tenon saw because of how fine the TPI is, so 2/3 inch, and we'll go from there. So I can just pretty much hold the chuck. I do believe I am slightly hitting one of the jaws, but I think it should be fine. Now I'm definitely hitting a jaw, or I'm not hitting it, I'm rubbing against it. So just spin it around a tiny bit. And there we go. So it's nice and flush. And I've also damaged the end of my chuck again. So I'll just be able to file that back down. Didn't really want to do that. Tenon saw's alright though. You can just probably see some silver where the paint's sort of been rubbed off. So if I grab the chuck key, wherever I have put the chuck key. Now, there it is. Take this excess out. Can get the chuck key in. There we go. Open it right up. And now we have a little biscuit. So guys, I've pretty much run out of orbital sander disc pads, so I've just propped it in the vise and I'm pretty much removing the rest with the Tenon saw and just go really nicely and steady. Luckily it's not marking it because I'm putting no pressure. So now it's flush and we'll just finish it off with sander. There we go. Why does that look so light? Oh, it's my camera. So there we are, finished product.